Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're going to be talking about performance modifications and upgrades for the 5.3 liter EcoTec3 engine used in Chevy Silverado, Sierras, and a number of other GM SUVs. The 5.3 liter is a naturally aspirated V8. It's been produced since 2014, and so power levels from the factory do vary and depend on what year or model you have. But in this video, we're going to go ahead and talk about some basic bolt-on modifications that will work for any year 5.3 liter EcoTec3. And this list of modifications will add anywhere from about 50 to 80 horsepower, and that's going to be excluding camshaft upgrades, which we will talk about a little bit. For the most part, we're going to be talking about your basic bolt-on modifications. There are, of course, a number of other more advanced modifications that you can do, like porting and polishing the heads to be able to get more power, more aggressive camshafts. You've got forced induction, superchargers, and turbochargers. So when we look at performance modifications as a whole, there are a ton of different routes that you can go. So in this guide, we're going to be talking about your typical tuning, cold air intakes, headers, Catback exhaust systems, we'll talk about E85 fueling, we'll talk about throttle body upgrades, and then I will mention camshafts briefly. But anything more advanced than that, we'll go ahead and save for later on. With that being said, let's go ahead and jump into the list of modifications we have here. Number one on the list is gonna be tuning. Tuning is where your big power gains are gonna come from. It's also really gonna help optimize all these other modifications that we do. The best combination is all of these other mods plus tuning to really maximize the power gains that you're getting out of the 5.3 liter V8. Just from tuning alone, you can typically see about 15 to 25 horsepower and about 15 to 25 torque. However, that will compound a little bit when we combine some of these other modifications with it. So tuning is the best base. It's going to be something that you'll want to do likely after you have your mod list picked out and have done some of those first basic modifications, just to make sure you really fine tune the tuning for all of the other things that you're adding to your engine as well. After tuning, or in conjunction with tuning, some of the things that we like to do are cold air intake upgrades. Cold air intakes are going to be a little bit lower on the power gain side of things, but once we add tuning and start talking about making more horsepower, it is helpful to bring more air into the engine, because the faster we can get air into the engine and air out of the engine, the more horsepower we can make. With the cold air intake upgrade, you can typically get around 5 to 8 horsepower gains out of it, and it's going to help optimize the airflow. It's going to help bring more air into the engine, and that's also going to help with some of these other modifications that we're talking about, and really help optimize for the tuning as well. After a cold air intake and tuning, now we need to focus on getting air out of the engine. The most restrictive part of the exhaust system is going to be the exhaust manifolds. So you're going to want to go ahead and replace the exhaust manifolds with a set of performance headers. Now with headers, you can either go short tube, which will keep your truck emissions compliant, or you can go long tube and do a cat delete, which is going to offer the biggest power gains. However, it will of course come with the caveat of the emissions situation. Ultimately, long tube headers are going to be the best from a power gain standpoint. Just from the headers alone, you'll likely see about 15 to 20 horsepower, and that will also pair very well with an upgraded Catback exhaust system. But the biggest power gains are going to come from the headers. You can opt for some short tube headers. Your power gains are likely going to be a little bit closer to the 10 horsepower mark rather than 15 to 20 that you get with the long tube and deleting the emissions equipment, but it will keep you emissions compliant. And that, of course, brings us to the fourth thing, which is a Catback exhaust system. Now, the Catback occurs after the catalytic converters, so back pressure reduction within the Catback portion of the exhaust isn't quite as valuable as it is within the headers, so you're going to see smaller power gains coming from the Catback exhaust system, likely somewhere around maybe 5 to 8 horsepower. But when you combine these with headers, it'll really help optimize airflow out of the engine, and that will help improve power and help get air in and out of the engine more quickly, as we discussed. Ultimately, doing a full exhaust setup is going to be a good source of power gains on these engines as well. So those are really your standard basic bolt-on modifications. If you're looking for, you know, simple power gains, you're not looking to spend too much money or get into anything really advanced, then just a simple exhaust system, intake, and tuning are going to be the best places to start. But we do have a few other things on this list to discuss that are also a little bit more bolt-on as well. Next up is going to be E85 fueling. Some of the 5.3 liters came flex fuel capable, and some of them didn't. The ones that aren't flex fuel capable can be upgraded by upgrading the fuel pump to be able to handle 100% E85. But if your vehicle is E85 compatible, then the best free performance modification you can do is use E85 fueling. E85 burns at a way higher octane rating than your traditional 85, 87, or even 91 octane gas. E85 burns a little bit closer to the 105 to 108 octane rating, so it's very similar to running like a race gas in your truck. And naturally, just by running a higher octane gas like E85, you're gonna get some pretty good power gains out of it. So just from running E85, you'll get about 10 to 15 horsepower gains. And if your truck's already flex fuel capable, you can do this for free. All you need to do is go and fill up at an E85 station. Now, one of the best things that you can do when it comes to tuning as well is to tune your truck specifically for E85 fuels. If you do tuning and tune for E85, that's how you're gonna see some of the biggest power gains that you can get out of one of these 5.3 liters without getting into forced induction camshafts and other major engine and block upgrades. After E85 fueling, we have throttle body upgrades. You can't upgrade the throttle body. However, you're typically only gonna see maybe 2 to 3, maybe 5 horsepower gains out of upgrading the throttle body. So there's not a whole lot of performance benefit for it. This is something that I would say probably hold off on unless you're getting to the point of really trying to maximize airflow and maximize your power gains with bolt-on modifications. And then this brings us up to the 7th upgrade on our list, and that is camshafts. Depending on what year model and what your factory horsepower is, a camshaft is probably going to be necessary for you to brake a little bit past the 400 crank horsepower levels. So if you go with a modest stage 1 camshaft, that can help you get some pretty solid power gains without really impacting a whole lot of daily drivability. There, of course, are more advanced camshaft upgrades that you can do, like stage 2 or stage 3 camshafts, that can give you 50, 75, 100 horsepower gains. But those are gonna severely impact your drivability. So those are probably more so reserved for people that are doing more serious builds or trying to do something a little bit more unique that's not their daily driver. So stage 1 camshaft upgrades are a good option. And of course, while you're doing a camshaft upgrade, you should also do an AFM or DOD delete on it. If you aren't gonna do a DOD delete, then I 100% recommend also running one of our boost AFM and DFM disablers to go ahead and make sure your truck's running in V8 mode all the time to help protect your lifters from failing. But if you go ahead and jump in there and do the camshaft, then you can go ahead and do a DOD delete and tune it out with your custom tuning so you won't need a device like this. So guys, that covers it for the 7 modifications here. Not including camshafts, you can see about 50 to 80 horsepower power gains. And that is, of course, depending on the tuning as well as the fueling that you're running. To get closer to that 80 horsepower mark, you're gonna be wanting to run E85 fueling with proper E85 tuning. And then, of course, if you want to go ahead and add in a stage 1 or a really moderate camshaft, you can go ahead and get those power gains up even further from there, and that'll help you break into the 400 plus horsepower mark at the crankshaft, depending on how much horsepower your truck came from the factory. Now, one of the reasons that we aren't getting into some of the more advanced things here is because you very quickly start to rack up the dollar signs once we start talking about breaking into the engine. And even the same is true with camshaft upgrades. The reason that I say that that's a more advanced modification is because you actually have to crack into the engine to upgrade the camshaft. If you aren't a serious DIYer, you're probably gonna need to pay a shop to do it, and then it can get quite expensive from there. Ultimately, if you're looking for basic bolt-on modifications, you know, you're looking to do all of the installs yourself, save yourself some money, and really get some decent power gains for an affordable price, then sticking to tuning, intakes, and exhaust systems is going to be your easiest option. But as I mentioned, we will go ahead and do some more videos on advanced modifications like forced induction, camshafts, so on and so forth in future videos. So if you guys appreciate this content, please subscribe to our channel, click the like button, and stay tuned for all the future content.